ini adalah
So, we have collected the EFB, which is empty fruit bunch, like this one, okay? So, after we have shred, it will be like this. And then the second one, the second substrate is the palm fruit, which is we will use the fiber from the palm oil company.
Okay, we also work with palm oil solid waste. So, here in front of the camera, you can see a type of waste that we use. Okay, the first type is this one. This is shredded palm oil empty fruit bunch. So, the empty fruit bunch is this stuff. So, this is originally, when you shred, you get this stuff. So, you can see the what I call the consistency or the texture of the EFB is like this lah. So, same like this, as you can see here. At the tangkai here, at the bunch there, and also at this part, the what I call the texture is like a coarse fiber. Okay, so when you shred this, you get this stuff. Okay, and the what we call the on this bunch, normally the palm fruit will be there lah. So the palm fruit itself have some what we call fibrous. It's very fibrous. They have the outer layer is fibrous part lah. So when you shred that fiber, the fruit fiber, you get this. This is what we call palm press fiber, meaning that the fiber from the kernel or the fruit of the palm oil being crushed to get the oil, and this is what left over lah. So this is palm press fiber lah. So you can see if you look the difference between the EFB, they are a little bit finer. If you can compare, you compare here. The palm fruit fiber is finer compared to the EFB. So that's how you differentiate between these two lah. And also the color normally is darker than EFB. EFB typically like this, the brownish color. Okay. And also we also have this palm kernel, okay, palm kernel shell. So this already being crushed. We don't have the original one. We only have the original for EFB. And also the PPF. This is palm fruit fiber lah. Okay, palm press fiber or palm fruit fiber. But we don't have this the kernel, the original one for this. Most of it is already being crushed. But here we have two kernel that we found somewhere. But this is type of the palm kernel. Okay, inside this they are like the fat, the white fat. If you open this thing lah. But this is a palm kernel shell. So when you crush this stuff, you get this. Okay, we already crush everything. And this kernel is quite heavy. So the density is much, much higher lah compared to this PPF or EFB. This is example of the one that we already crushed before. So this is press fiber. So you can see the consistency of this press fiber like that. And the one on the side is EFB. Okay, EFB. So this is EFB, the shredded, the crushed shredded EFB. Okay, so you can see the color different between this. This is EFB. This is a palm press fiber or palm fruit fiber. One more thing, you need to make sure if you want to, if let's say you want to crush like this, the sample that you collect from the factory must be kept dry lah. If you don't dry this, then you will find that this sample will be contaminated with the typically the orange mold lah. The mold orange and like the color is orange. Same like this thing lah. Because this is a very what I call they have a lot of not nutrient but the fungus like it. So it, normally when you take from the factory, it's wet. You need to dry it immediately. If you wait for even one day, then the next day you will find that the sting full of the orange mold. So this we can put in this what we call plastic bag, because we already thoroughly dry this for a few days, and then we put some up to some silica gel inside lah. But for the silica gel, if you look here, can you take it? Okay, if you look here, you need to make sure your silica gel is active. This is already full lah. I mean that it's already full with water inside, moisture inside. The active one normally is orange in color like this. Okay, so this, when the color change into pale like this, meaning that all the pores within this silica gel already being absorbed, full with water lah, water molecule and so on. So the way how you prepare the silica gel is by putting the silica within the holy pouch like this. Okay, so you can see the next video how it's done. This is how we prepare our silica gel pouch, where we use this to reduce the moisture content within the container when we put our sample, so that our sample can be stored for a long time. So we buy a large quantity of silica gel in this container, and then we put it inside this pouch that have some hole structure here. For example, there are some hole structure so that the moisture can go inside and being absorbed by the silica gel. So we use this the orange type of silica gel, because it's, if you look here, it's heavy from metal. It's free from heavy metal compared to the blue one. Although it can change the color, but the blue one is more toxic. So the orange one is typically used for dry the food based ingredient. Okay. Here we knot it twice, because we don't want the what we call the silica gel coming out. So this is the end result that we see. Okay, because EFB and also this palm fruit fiber have the texture like coconut fiber, so the way how to crush it is more or less the same lah. Okay, so as you can see here, we make like a ball so that the blade can catch the sample. Okay, if you just put it like this, open like this, then the blade may have some difficulties lah to register this stuff. Okay, because it itself is less what we call less dense, so you need to make it denser like this. Okay, so you put it ball by ball slowly like that. And then here, you can see at the bottom here, this is how it's look lah. Okay, so you can see here, this is the crush EFB. Okay, so now we crushing the EFB. So the flow rate is more or less like that lah. Okay, it goes down, it's quite fast, but you need to do it slowly lah, because to avoid this from being, from being stuck. Okay. Stop. Okay. So, jap. Tengok ada suara. So, basically, we just stop our crusher just now, because you can hear just now the sound is quite different than before. That means something stuck there. So, let's open this thing. The reason why this thing stuck is because you try to put this too much at one time. You just ram everything in one go. You need to put it ball by ball, only then it will go slowly. So you can see here what happened. Okay, close everything first. It's very important for you when you want to work with this, even though there are safety pin there, but then it's better to close everything. This is the main power. Okay, close like that, and then only then you can work with this, because we don't want anything dangerous happen. So you can see the EFB is too much. You put too much EFB at one go, and see what happened here. The blade will be stuck. Okay, so you can see there. So you can see this how what we call the blade start. This thing is fibrous, so fiber is flexible, and you can see when it's stuck, then it's quite. You need to what we call disentangle all this fiber one by one lah, because you can see. Okay, you can try. So it's better for you when you use, when you want to crush the EFB, you do it slowly, ball by ball, because that will save you more time than this. Even though you think that by putting everything in one go will make your job faster, but this cleaning and what we call taking out the stuck EFB fiber will take more time than that. Okay, so for fibrous sample, you must do it slowly. Put it, make it aggregate like a ball, and do it one by one. So here you can see, it's quite difficult. So you need to push like that. Sometimes you can use like a tool. Ada tool tak aneh. Sometimes you take like a tool like this, because you can just pull. Sometimes if it's hard to pull this way, you do other ways lah. You do other ways like this. Okay, ha. So it's like that. Okay. So that's how it will. It ni lah. So now it's already moving lah. So that's why it's important for you to close all the power, because imagine now this moving, then yeah, you lost a hand. Okay. Okay. Now we want to crush our palm fruit fiber. Okay. So this palm fruit fiber. So we crush here. The idea is similar to how you crush the EFB or coconut oil. You just need to make like a ball here first, and then you put one by one lah, like that. Pull it one by one like that, and so on. So this, and then pull like that. And you can see at the bottom here, that's the flow rate, how the shredded PPF coming down. And you can see here the texture. The texture there. Okay. So this is our crush palm press fiber or palm fruit fiber. Okay. Okay. So ball by ball, you need to do one by one. Okay. Usually the fiber you need to be patient a little bit lah. But if you use like something hard like coconut or coconut shell or cocoa pod, it will be faster. But for fiber, you need to make like a ball and let it go in slowly one by one. So I think that's it for crushing, because the idea is the same like before. You just crush like that. Just be patient.